And welcome to The Crack of Dawn with me, Ricky.
And I'm Jennifer Crystal. Oh, we're in for a treat today, Ricky Rendell.
I know. When I saw today's lineup, I almost jumped out of me pants.
So as you're wearing any.
Late start or early finish? Party girl.
At least I still have friends to party with.
Oh yeah? Homeless and the mentally ill don't count,
yeah. Yeah, Ricky, well they should. Your parents are great company. But moving on quickly.
Like all your ex-husbands did. I'm sorry, I just couldn't resist. As always, we at The Crack It's On will serve you up your greasy morning fry of interviews, hot gossip with lashings of music, competitions and loads more cure shy to wake yous up on a Saturday morning.
So why not stay with us for a little while, try something a little different?
We do like to be different here.
I eat chips, cheese, garlic every morning for breakfast.
I know. Haven't you noticed me safe distance, what?
Yeah, Ricky, have you noticed? That's exactly why I do it.
Anyway, before all of that, let's go over and get the news and weather with Russell Bush and his man friends.
Thank you, Ricky and Jennifer. A man was found dead last night with 46 stab wounds to his nose. The Gardaí are treating it as suspicious, obviously. They say they have not ruled out suicide, but all signs point to foul play. The man was known to be an associate with the well-known chicken gang, the Clucks. When asked if they had any other leads, the Gardaí said, "No, that's about it, really." When a man on the street was questioned, his reply was, "Jesus, was that Tommy?" Tragedy on the roads of the countryside today as the death of 16 sends a wave of despair throughout the clown community. The driver of the delightfully colored bus, who was also a clown, lost control when he pressed the horn and water splashed in his face. Although hilarious, he could not see and drove straight off the cliff. Only one survived the brutal waters below, swimming, the water clown. He is said to be stable but in shock. He can't believe how busy he's going to be now that the rest are gone. The men were traveling to a Will Smith concert to perform in his dressing room on their way to the show. The end of the world has come and gone, and we're all still here, and we're kind of disappointed. That is the feeling of 23% of the 13% that made their way to the 11% of safety zones that are still being used by 33% in fear of doomsday, according to a recent report by lots of numbers, people. Those that flocked to the mountains or below ground were hoping for something after all the fuss. They were full sure that the Mayans were correct in their predictions. How could you not trust the predictions of a people who were almost extinct but didn't see that coming? Anyway, watch out for these fools who thought the end was nigh. They may look to force the issue. That isn't even written down here. I just don't trust extremists, and you shouldn't either. Go get yourself some guns. In sport, footballers are overpaid, and a lot of women tennis players look like men. Now to our man in the field, Bill Williamson.
Yes, thank you, Russell Bush. I'm here today to look at... Jesus fucking Christ!
And in breaking news, our man in the field, Bill Williamson, an old man with his pants down and a prize-winning cock are all probably dead due to a failed rocket launch. That's all from me.
Thank you, Russell Bush, and sweet sunny baby, and of course, God bless the dead.
Yes, our thoughts are with you and your families. Now, without further ado, because the anticipation is just killing me, what did you get up to this week, Jen?
Well, Ricky Rendell, I went to visit superstar chef Biff O'Grady, and he taught me how to make beauty from nothing.
I bet this is terrible.
Really? Have you something to say about him?
I just think I could do what he does.
Why don't you?
Because, Jen, I like to sprinkle my food with a little thing called dignity. Of course, you wouldn't know much about that now, would you?
Oh, Ricky Rendell, do I detect a hint of jealousy? Do you sprinkle your food with that also? Because that is not good for you.
Yeah? Neither's mixing your drinks with borderline prostitution, love. But you seem to be doing all right out of it.
Interesting you should say that, Ricky Rendell. I was going through your book, The Rendell Man. Came across a little story on page 67.
Hello.
Hello.
Oh, is this at my door? Please, come in.
Thank you. I'm here today with Chef Biff O'Grady. It's quite an honour to be your guest, I must admit. I am a fan.
It's actually my mother's home you were a guest in. I live in a mansion. But I thought I'd bring you here, because this is where it all began. And of course, I love my mother.
Aww, that's lovely. And are you going to cook for me?
Oh yes. A recipe from my new DVD, Simple But Love.
Ah.
To start with the bread, you know, but I like to freshen it up, you know. Chose boss.
It's the simple ingredients that I love.
Yeah.
So doable.
Yeah, we're going to pop these into the toaster here. This should be a couple of minutes. But you know, it's hard up there, you know. I know that fact. And I like to get back.
Oh yeah, defo. Mm.
Just going to grab my bread and cheese here.
Oh my God, look at that.
Yeah. You know, cooking is sensual, you know. If you can't feel it, you can't meal it.
Wow, a little rhyme.
There we go. Yeah, the toast is done. I like to start off with chef.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, chef has got to give it a good kick, you know.
Mm.
Really good, I like the taste. Mm. Strong taste, you know. So we're just going to dollop that on there. You don't be afraid. Don't be afraid of it. Get it all on there, you know.
Yeah.
And then we're going to get some mayo. I do like mayo, you know, creamy stuff.
Oh, yeah.
It's a real another bang.
How did you get so good?
Oh, well, I showed signs of cooking greatness when I was only 7 months old. Yeah, you see, my mother gave me a piece of chocolate. And she watched with amazement as I combined it with a biscuit and ate the two together. Yeah, then 2 months later, my first words were actually bisque bar.
Oh yeah. My God.
It's the name of the recipe. You see, I think it's fair to say I was a child prodigy.
You're kind of like the Tiger Woods of cooking, so.
Yes, we're up to swinging.
Wow, it's so good.
You were a woman. Man, you feel you'd say that.
Well, I'm gonna stay here and finish these delicious treats with Chef before Grady. So why don't you go back and see what rubbish Ricky Randall is up to?
Before the clock hits midnight on one of our earthly days, a hero. Born to rise from the status of mortal to something more everlasting. A place in the club of legends.
Lionel Messi. Can you hear the Michael Jordan. Muhammad Ali. I
remember long. Names on the lips of many. Masters of the universe. These are the standing tall. The lion of the jungle. The nut in the nuts. The it in the shit. But I'm looking for the slight opposite. Those that have the love, the dedication, the drive, and sadly no talent. God didn't like them enough, or whatever. And yet they persevere, and give the game they love all they can. Are they not heroes?
Not long after I began my search, I heard of a boxer named Mad Mario, aka the Italian Medallion. I had to meet him.
Ah, doing a bit of training, are we?
Always, man, I never stop.
And why is that?
Because I love it.
Well, you'd have to love it with your record.
Listen, the sweet sciences. It's not about winning, it's about having respect. For the sport, you know?
And tell me, what's this about you being banned from the local gyms?
What? For fuck's sake, so what? We fight us, so I had a few disagreements. Fuck that shit, man. Fuck that shit.
Well, I heard it was too dangerous to let you fight. Too dangerous for you, that is.
Oh, here we go, mother. You want to see me in action? You want to see me go?
Well, yeah, that was part of it.
Okay, Big Skinny. Get that motherfucker. Bring on Big Skinny. Bring him on. Bring on that motherfucker. I'm gonna show you that kick! Them cameras rolling, make sure they get my good side! Who are you? You pussy! Yeah! Pussy! Skill! Pussy! Pussy! Fucking eye is the greatest! Pussy! Fuck it, you bitch! You heterosexual, you!
What did you call me?
Fuck!
There was something in the air that night. The stars.
sacrifice, commitment, the willingness to die for one's passion. Tony, could you break that up? That doesn't look too healthy at all. Now, pussy. Where was I?
Pussy.
Ah, yes. Oh, yeah. Mad Mario, the Italian legend. He had all those qualities needed of a true champion. But the talent of a tin opener is a missing link. He's a Supremes without Diana Ross. Cornflakes without milk. Jennifer Crystal without alcohol. In this world, you need them all to sit on the throne. Without them all, it's your world to worship. Or to keep getting knocked the fuck out.
What the fuck are you talking about, man? That must stop them in technicality. I don't see no big...
Well, that was interesting.
Thanks for that, Jen.
So's didgeridoo doesn't mean I like it.
Well, I guess that makes you my didgeridoo then.
That makes no sense.
I'll drink it up, bitch. Our next guest requires no introduction, but I get paid to give one. And even if I didn't get paid to give one, I would still give this screen legend his due praise. Ladies and gentlemen, get to the chopper! Can't do the accent. It's only bleeding Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Please, Mrs. Schwarzenegger, take a seat.
Thank you, and please call me Annie, or the funny horse who loves the daffodil.
It's great to have you here.
Yes, I'm very excited. I am back.
Oh, wow, you actually do that in real life too.
Do what?
The I'll be back thing.
I'm back with a new box office smash.
And again.
So tell us about it.
In this one scene, everything on the island is blown up. When I come flying through the special effects on my T-Rex, Cecil, and I grab my machine gun and I shoot the bad guy in the testicles. And I said to these even badder bad guys, you are worse than the people that created this place. When they said to me, we are the people that created this place. Then I said to them, then you are even worse than yourselves.
Wow, sounds epic.
Arnie, was that the ending?
I'll be back.
Arnie, you've done it again.
Done what?
The I'll be back thing.
No, I didn't.
Anyway, Arnie, what's life like away from politics?
I'll be back.
To politics.
Funny horse who loves the daffodil. Do you even know what bleeding day of the week it is?
Do you think that you could speak to me like that, you puny presenter? I'm a former Mr. Universe, you idiot. Now stand up like a man in this studio.
Yeah, Ricky.
Oh, yeah. There's only one thing I'd rather do more than kick the Terminator's ass.
Then come on. Do it, I'm right here. Now you get to the chopper and you go
all
now.
Right, right.
And you go, come on. Because I might, I'll kill you. Come on, come on. I'll kill you. Come on.
Try so hard to understand their men. Such blind faith should be forgiven. The mind is so different between his and hers. He keeps his in his pants. Where's yours? 'Cause every man has got a cock in his pants. Something happened to my willy that would fucking kill me. So maybe try to treat it like an adorable pet. Love and care and tend to my red rocket. Hugs and fucking kisses, bedtime stories in the night. Be a little rough with it, just don't bite. It ain't my fault, it's just the way it goes. 'Cause every man got a cock in his pants. And all that cock wants to do is dance. Every man has got a cock in his pants. And all that cock wants to do is dance.
myself in my head. Fucking love myself.
Fucking love myself.